Who am I that the highest King would welcome me? I was lost, but he brought me in. Oh, his love for me. Oh, his love for me. Who the sun sets free. Oh, is free.
Hi guys, my name is Jonathan and welcome to TC Youth. If you're new here, we're so glad to have you as a part of our new family member. We're about to go through some announcements here, so stay tuned to know how to get plugged in. First up, we have online devos happening throughout the week. So devotionals are ways that we can do to study the Bible, or we can talk, or we can just update each other on what's been going on with our lives. If you want to know more information about it, please contact your tribe leader. But if you're not part of a tribe yet, don't worry. You can message us down in the chat below, or you can chat us in the Zoom. Or even better, you can just DM us on Instagram at thecollective.youth. Next up, we have Friday Fuels happening every week, every Friday at 8 p.m. That's when we usually watch movies, we play games, or sometimes we can even do Instagram lives. For more information, please follow us on Instagram at thecollective.youth. We hope that you can join us the fun this Friday. And then next up, we have offline services every Saturday at Citibank Pondok Indah at 4 p.m. So come and join us. We can worship together. We can hang out after that. But don't worry, if you can't make it, we're going to have an online service as well. And it's going to be starting at 3 p.m. on Zoom. We'll see you on both services. And last but not least, we have a Christmas party happening next week at the 11th of December. It's going to be happening right here also at TC Pondok Indah Citibank at 4 p.m. Let's join us for the Christmas party event as well. So, without further ado, let's jump into the sermon. Bye.
What is up, TC Youth fam, and welcome to part two of They Didn't See It Coming. Look, I talked about how Jesus was a common king that the Jewish people didn't see it coming. In fact, for us, as people, a lot of us, maybe we grew up in church where we always saw Jesus as this faraway person. He's too good for us. He's too royal. He's perfect. You know, if I could just reach Jesus in the standard he wants me to. But the reality of Jesus is that he's a common king. He's someone that he didn't stay in heaven or stay far away from us in his royal palace, but he born himself into normalness, into nothing, so that we who were normal or felt like we were nothing could have who he was in heaven. That's a beautiful thing about Jesus. He's this coming king that the Jewish people, or even us, we didn't see coming. You know, see, in this series, we're talking about how they, the Jewish people, didn't see it coming, or how we also didn't see Jesus coming as this person that we thought he would be. And so last week, again, as we talked about, he was our common king. And today we're going to talk about how Jesus is the king of peace. They didn't see a peaceful king coming. Have you guys ever been in a surprise party before? You know, I remember when I was 22 and I called it my Taylor Swift year, right? Because that's like the song she wrote. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling 22, right? Like, I remember when that song came out and I was like turning 22 and I just thought, this is my glory year, you know, 11-11 plus that, 22. And I remember, you know, some of my friends are so sweet. They wanted to plan a surprise party for me. And then what ended up happening is I actually, like some of you guys know Pastor Gio, right? So Gio, one of my best friends, we were out somewhere and they were planning this behind-the-scenes surprise birthday party for me that I had no clue about. But then I was with Gio, and Gio accidentally let it slip out of his mouth. He was like, oh, hey, are you coming tonight? And I was like, to what? And he was like, I don't know. And it was like on my birthday, right? And he was like, I don't know. And then at that point, you know, I kind of had this hunch that I had this surprise party. And so most of us, when there's a surprise party, you know, sometimes if we find out about it, you know, we try to act surprised, or sometimes people don't pick up the hint and they walk into the party and they get surprised. And I also know that there's some people out there that don't like surprises. So, you know, if this is not applicable to you, just stay tuned. But long story short, I found out there was a surprise party for me and I was so honored and I loved it so much. But then I thought, you know, it'd be fun. What if I surprise the people that are going to surprise me for my party? So this is happening at Alex's house, right? It's the 22nd. It's my 22nd birthday. And, you know, I decided, like, I kind of caught wind of when people were going to be showing up. So then I decided to, when people were thinking, like, I was going to arrive at the door and come in, and people thought I was going to show up in the door, I ended up surprising people. So while everyone's in the living room, I decided to go through Alex's backyard, or not backyard, his garage, that had a staircase that led to the back of his kitchen. And I go up to the staircase, and everyone's just, like, kind of waiting for, like, what's going to happen. So I go up to the back staircase, and I open the door quietly, and then people are just like, the room's all dark, people are waiting for me to walk in, and I literally just walk into like the back, and then everyone's just waiting, they're looking towards the door, and I come in behind people, and I'm like, what's everyone waiting for? And then someone turns around, they're like, oh, we're waiting for Jordan. And they're like, Jordan? And then I was like, surprise, right? And they didn't see it coming. They didn't see me coming to surprise them for my own surprise birthday party. Now see, what's so interesting about that surprise is, as people didn't see it coming, it's because they didn't expect the outcome to be from what they thought in their heads. And see, in the same way, when we think about Jesus, see, all throughout scripture, these Jewish people, they have the Old Testament. Now, this Old Testament, they picture Jesus as this king that's going to come and revolutionize the world. In fact, when you think about all of the Old Testament, you have guys like King David, King Solomon, all these different judges and kings that came to liberate Israel out of times that they were enslaved. So these Jewish people had this preconceived notion that, like, we're going to finally get this Messiah that's going to free us from this oppressive regime that's always over us. The life of the Jewish people is always like, we're on top, we're at the bottom, we're on top, we're at the bottom, we're on top, we're at the bottom. So their preconceived notion of Jesus was going to be one of a king that's going to overcome and bring a war and get us so that we're finally on top of nations. We're going to be victorious, just like all the other, all of our countrymen from the past and generations before us. Now see, what's so interesting is when we actually look at the life of Jesus through the Gospels, we don't see that. We see the opposite of a God that comes to bring war. We see the opposite, and that's a God that comes to bring peace. So I want to pick up here in Luke chapter 2, and we're continuing from the moment that Jesus is born in the manger. Because, again, these Jewish people were expecting royalty and a king that's going to be on top, and he's going to overthrow kingdoms and all this stuff, right? That's what they're expecting. But continuing from a Jesus that was born a common king in a manger, we're going to pick up here in Luke chapter 2, and this is in verse 8. And this is going to take place in the story where Jesus, or an angel, sorry, not Jesus, but an angel appears to shepherds. Now, the historical context of shepherds is this, that shepherds at this time were considered in the lower caste system of society, of Jewish society. So these lower caste system of people, as they were in the lower part of society, you know, they were kind of always considered on the outside. They were on the outside because, number one, they were taking care of sheep, but they're also on the outside because of their financial class, and on the outside because they were considered dirty. Right? They're dirty for taking care of these animals, and because they're dirty, they're unclean before God. And so check this out. This is what it says in verse 8. It says, that night, the night that Jesus was born in the manger, there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Now suddenly an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terrified. But the angel reassured them, "Don't be afraid," he said. "I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been today in Bethlehem, the city of David. And you will recognize him by this sign. You will find a baby wrapped snugly in strips of cloth, lying in a manger." Wrapped snugly. You know, I just picture like little cute anime Jesus, right? Suddenly, the angel, joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased." When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." See, we have this beautiful story of these shepherds that have been on the outside, kind of looked down on from society, kind of people that were looked down on because of their social status. And we have these angels, literally picture you're these three shepherds that are watching your sheep. And all of a sudden you see like these bright lights and the heavens open. And all of a sudden you see all these angels and like these people with trumpets and these armies and these people that are up in heaven, just praising God. And obviously, like, I'm not gonna lie, if I was a shepherd, I would be freaked out. I would be afraid. I'd be like, what the heck is going on? And these angels are coming, they're speaking to these shepherds, and they're saying, "Hey, don't be afraid. I bring you good news that brings you great joy." Wow, what a powerful message. These shepherds are like, "What? I bring good news that brings great joy?" That's crazy. And then the verses go on, and it says this in, let me get it up here so I have to read it. It says this in verse 14 and 15, like the angels and like all these armies, they're declaring this, and they say this: "Glory to God in highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased." I love that. Peace on earth to those whom God is pleased. Well, why would God show himself to lowly shepherds? Why would God reveal himself in one of the biggest ways to people that were in the lowest position? See, I think the shepherds kind of, maybe they live with this perspective that, you know, I'm just always going to be distant from God. There's going to be this chasm between me and God. There's going to be this chasm because of my life versus the life that God wants me to live. And see, at this time, I think these shepherds grew up with this expectation of, well, I'm never going to reach God. There's this divisive line. And because of that, I have no peace with God. And if I have no peace with God, then therefore I have no peace in life. And if I have no peace in life, well, then life is only up to me, how I can reconcile and work life for myself. See, why is it so important that we have this King of Peace coming to us? Is that Jesus came to say, hey, for you that do not have peace, for you that do not, that are yearning for peace, but haven't found it in your own circumstances, well, guess what? The Prince of Peace is coming to you. See, for some of us in here, we might not have peace in our life because we feel like we've sinned. We feel like we've just never been good enough. We feel like there's a lot of anxieties and insecurities and broken things in our life. Things that we feel like aren't right in our situations, whether it's family, whether it's school, whether it's self, whether it's mental issues or emotional issues, all those things. And we felt this way, and these things have not brought us peace. In fact, it's created chaos. But Jesus, he wants to come in and he says that, hey, I am peace. I am the Prince of Peace, or he's a peaceful king that comes to, Jesus came to bring the divide from God to us so that it's God in us. God in us right here. In fact, this is what it says in the verse of Isaiah. Check this out. It says this in verse 9, chapter 9 of Isaiah, verse 6. And this is like an Old Testament prophecy for the coming Jesus. It's going to come. But it says this, for to us a child is born, to us a son is given. The government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. Prince of Peace. See, there's this prophecy coming that Jesus is going to come and he's going to be a Wonderful Counselor, a Mighty God, an Everlasting Father. And he's the Prince of Peace. See, why is this so important? Literally, the embodiment of Jesus is peace. Why is a peaceful king coming so important? Is because, man, for us that don't have peace, well, now we can have peace in Jesus. Because one of the ways that we know we can have peace is that you can know that, man, because your Father in heaven it wants closeness with you. Jesus has brought this heaven to us, peace to us. The common king has brought peace between me and God. And because of that, you never have to be afraid of God feeling as if he's going to be distant and far from you. No, he tore that apart and he said, no, God always wants closeness with you. And now you can have peace because now you can know, man, God's never going to let me down. God's never going to leave me or forsake me. I have peace because God is for me. See, TC Youth, now your takeaway in this is this, that now you know because you can have always a relationship with God throughout all of your life, because of that now, God can also reconcile your relationships with others. See, sometimes when we're afraid that this relationship between us and God can be severed, sometimes that can also mean that our relationships with others can be severed. But because Jesus has reconciled and brought peace between us and God, now we can also work on reconciliation and restoration between our relationship with others, our relationship in our current circumstances, our life in our current circumstances. God desires to bring peace throughout all of our life. See, TC Youth, why Jesus coming, or why they didn't see a peaceful king coming, is because they saw a king that's going to bring chaos and war and a place for us to become like number one and overthrow kingdoms and be right in situations. But Jesus didn't come for us to be number one. Jesus called for us to be together. Jesus called for us to be one with God and one with others. See, that's a peaceful king, and that's the king that they didn't see coming. TC Youths, let's take away that thought that you have access to a God that comes to bring you peace. And now you can use that peace to bring peace bearers to others. Let's close in some prayer. Jesus, thank you for today. I pray that you would remind us that we are peace bringers because you are a peacemaker in our life. And so I pray that we would learn how to bring peace in every area of our life and know that there's peace in every situation and circumstance we face. So God, we thank you for this in Jesus' name. Amen. So God, love you guys. Catch us on Zoom. Join us in our online tribes or join us physically every Saturday at 4 p.m. Look, we love you guys and we'll see you guys next week. Bye, guys.